Okay, everybody, we're in the shop, this great big empty shop. Let's slow down the movement there. Nobody here but me. A little strange. Anyway, we have a lot of projects on the go. We have two J47s, an AI-25 that's going to fly again, and then our little junker that was melted and burnt up. So what I've done is I've come back to this one for a bit. We've taken off the HP turbine, and I'll show you that right now. It's right over here on the pile of junk. This is the forward face of it that we were not looking at before. The rear face is back there. So these little built-in spacers position the wheel on the shaft, and it's held in place. The HP turbine is held in place by these very, very fancy bolts. And what I've done is I've driven them back through their mounting holes, and this little clip was, you see that groove right in there? It was in there. So I probably should have just pulled the wheel off, but it was stuck on there in these little dowel sections. And now in order to get the thrust bearing for the HP turbine out, I've got to make a tool to undo this nut. That may or may not be taking place in the next couple days. And I've been taking out the segments of the HP nozzle. They are air-cooled for higher running temperatures. But what we can do now is we can look in and see the annular combustor. It looks very much like both a T58 with these little scooplets closer to us, and an LM2500 with the multiple fuel nozzles, even in the same trapezoidal shaped nests or housings or whatever you want to call it. That is the annular combustor of an AI-25. Cool. Okay, it's a little while later, and I've taken out this circle of bolts, little 8mm wrench bolts, or the M4s. Got a couple left. We'll see. We'll have a better look at the combustor liner once we take the HP nozzle case off. It's hung up on one. Yes. Okay. There we go. Yes, this is just the case that holds the HP nozzle. We'll set this aside. And let's take another look at that combustor liner. The combustor liner. In there. It's got a lot of the same structures we recognize from the T58. Doesn't it? Oh, there's pieces of the turbine blades. More junk in there. A little too much heat. The HP spins nice. Which is a little surprising because the HP system is connected to the gearbox, and when I was taking off the LP speed drive, there's an oil transfer tube about a half inch long that, as you can read, it was dropped down there and it went all the way down through both struts into the gearbox. So it's in there somewhere. would be a disaster, but this is a junk engine that's never going back together. But I'm amazed it hasn't been trapped between some gears. It still allows the HP system to turn just fine. All right. Okay, we've taken out all the fuel nozzles on the AI-25. Let's take a look at one. Oh, here's a bunch right there. Aren't they cute? Like a little GE-2500. And the pigtail fuel line is for thermal expansion. Let's take a look at down in the combustor. We're gonna pull this thing out in just a second. Okay, hang on. Okay, all the fuel nozzles are out, and here goes. It weighs about 15 pounds. There's the front of it. And here is the exit. It looks almost exactly like an LM2500 combustor. Don't you think? That is really cool. Okay, now we're going to take a look down there. All right, can we see anything down there? Oh yes, there's a bunch of debris. Look at that, used to be a turbine blade, or a couple of them. All that crap. This is the exit of the high pressure compressor into the combustor. And this strange looking metal squid, that's gonna hold the thrust bearing for the high pressure turbine. Okay. Right, we're getting into this thing. Stay tuned. All right, we're disassembling the AI-25, and with the help of Andre.
I'm Andre. I'm from Russia.
Excellent. Okay, I had to make this tool. This is a big one. We took off this nut, which held on the HP turbine shaft into the HP compressor shaft. This is the HP compressor shaft, and we've just taken off the combustor liner outer housing, or the combustor case. The combustor liner's out, and this is the back end of the compressor. Look at that, it turns just nice. This is these are labyrinth seals, and these are carbon seals, which we may be using. Very nice. Everything works quite well. Oh, look at that. That's the starter drive. See, when I turn this, look at it. See that? The gearbox is connected. Let's get them both in the shot. Isn't that cool? All right. So, until next time, until part 5, thanks for watching.